Welcome to the viewers for the lecture on structural analysis. In the last lecture, we have got the introduction, the equations, and the general procedure for the slope deflection method. Now, in this lecture, we'll take up a numerical example. First, let us start with a three-span continuous beam. First, we'll take up continuous beams, then we'll take up portal trusses, portal frames without and with sway, right? That's the now coming to the continuous beam, let us analyze a continuous beam ABCD of AB equal to 6 meters subjected to UDL over the entire span, BC of span 5 meters subjected to a non-central load 3 meters and 2 meters A and B, and the span CD with a central concentrated load of 80 kilonewton right at the center, right? Now coming to the moment of inertia for the span AB, moment of inertia is I naught. For the span BC, moment of inertia is 2 I naught, and for the span CD, moment of inertia is I naught. So span to span it can vary, but within a span, the one of the assumption is the beam is of constant section throughout, right? It cannot start with I at one end, 2 I at the other end. So that is assumption on which we do the slope deflection method problems, right? Now coming to this problem, so we know there are four steps. One is the determination of fixed end moments. Second is writing down the slope deflection equations. Third one is equilibrium equations, and fourth one is finding out the final moments and drawing the bending moment diagram and shear force diagram, right? Now we will start the problem. First step is fixed end moments. So what we do is we assume span AB to be a fixed beam subjected to UDL over the entire span, span BC as a fixed beam subjected to non-central load, and a span CD subjected to a central concentrated load. So this is what we treat the individual spans. We assume AB, BC and CD as fixed beams. So here when it is subjected to UDL, we know here it is minus WL square by 12, here it is plus WL square by 12. Here it is minus WA B square by L square. Now here it is W A square B by L square. Here it is minus W L by 8, and here it is plus W L by 8. So these values you are supposed to know, but initially in one problem I just write all these things. W L square by 12, here it is W L square by 12. So for various types of loadings, UDL, central load, non-central load, uniformly varying load, applying moment at center, applying moment at some other point, non-central moment, clockwise, anti-clockwise, all these things you must be able to deal. So this is now generally available in the form of a table in books. So this is very important, not only this method, the same determination of fixed end moments will be the first step in slope deflection method, moment distribution method, matrix flexibility method, matrix stiffness method. In all these things, without knowing how to determine the fixed end moments, you cannot do problems. So this is a very important thing, very important fundamental, right? Now coming to this, M of AB, M of AB equal to minus W L square by 12. W is 20, so minus 20. L is 6, W L square by 12. We have to find out the value. M of BA equal to plus W L square by 12 equal to plus 20 into 6 square by 12. This is for span AB. For span BC, M of BC equal to minus WA B square by L square equal to minus W is 50, A is 3 meters, B is 2 meters, WA B square by L square. L is 5 square. L is 5. L is 5 meters. Right. M of CB equal to plus W A square B by L square equal to 50 into 3 square into 2 by 5 square. Then M of CD, say M of CD equal to minus WL by 8, minus WL by 8 equal to minus 80, L is 5 meters by 8, and M of DC equal to plus WL by 8 equal to 80 into 5 by 8. So these are the formulas. Minus 60, this is minus 60 kilonewton meter, this is plus 60 kilonewton meter, minus 24, 36, and minus 50, and this is plus 50. So this is the first step. For moment distribution method also, you will have to do this as the first step, whatever may be the problem. This is the first step. So initially treat all spans as fixed like this and find out the fixed end moments. Now here, for convenience, we will write down the values here. Here it is minus 60, plus 60, minus 24, plus 36, minus 50, and plus 50. These are the fixed end moments, F. So for our convenience, we just return the values. So that is the first step. So second step is slope deflection equations. Slope deflection equations. So here there are three spans. We know for each span we have got two equations. We have equation for MAB, equation for MBA. This is in the span AB. Here we have equation for MBC, equation for MCB. So here we have equation for MCD and equation for MDC. So for three spans, we have 3 into 2, 6 equations. We have write down all the 6 equations, substitute the known values, delete the unwanted values, because we are writing, we have the most general equation, right? So that you have to simplify according to the problem and have it. We will have 6 equations, right? Now here, we know MAB equal to M of AB plus 2EI by L into 2 theta A plus theta B plus 3 delta by L. This is the general equation. Now here in this problem, A is fixed. A is fixed. Therefore, theta A equal to 0. D is fixed. D is fixed. Therefore, theta D equal to 0. And no mention about the settlement. Therefore, delta equal to 0 throughout. These are the known things. So, theta A equal to 0, theta D equal to 0. No mention about the settlement. Therefore, delta is 0 throughout. Right. So, this is the general equation. And here, we have M of AB equal to minus 60. Equal to minus 60 plus. One more point is, here I varies. Here it is I naught. Here it is 2 I naught. Again it is I naught. That has to be carefully accounted. Right. Now here 2 E I naught by L equal to 6 meters. L equal to 6 meters for the span AB. And theta A is 0. Delta is 0. Therefore, into theta B only. So, that's all. This, if you want, you can simplify as 1 by 3. So, this is equation number 1. This is one slope deflection equation. MBA equal to M of BA plus 2EI by L into B comes first. Therefore, 2 theta B plus theta A plus 3 delta by L. So, 3 delta by. So, this has to be very carefully written. So, 2 theta B plus theta A. Because it is M of B A, near end is B. Therefore, this is 2 theta B plus theta A plus 3 delta by L. Right. Now, here again, theta A is 0. Delta is 0. Therefore, equal to M of BA is plus 60. M of BA is plus 60. So, this is minus. That is plus 60. Therefore, it is 60 plus 2E. I equal to I naught. L equal to 6 meters into 2 theta B. This is equation number 2 for one span. Now, for the span BC, MBC equal to M of BC plus 2EI by L into 2 theta B plus theta C plus 3 delta by L. This is a general equation. So, in this, we have theta B as well as theta C. Both are there. Delta equal to 0. Delta equal to 0. Nothing is mentioned about the settlement. Therefore, M of BC is minus 24. This value, minus 24 plus 2E into I equal to 2 I naught for the span BC. For the span BC, I equal to 2 I naught. Therefore, 2E into 2 I naught by L equal to 5 meters. L equal to 5 meters into 2 theta B plus theta C. So, this is equation number 3. and MCB equal to M of CB plus 2EI by L into 2 theta C plus theta B. 2 theta C plus theta B. So here BC means 2 theta B plus theta C. CB means 2 theta C plus theta B. So this is to be written very carefully because that will cheat you. So you'll have to be a little careful. Plus 3 delta by L. Plus 3 delta by L. So here again delta equal to 0. Equal to 0. Therefore M of CB is plus 36. Equal to 36 plus 2E. I equal to 2 I naught by 5 meters into 2 theta C plus theta B. So this is equation number 4. Number 4. Now, for the span CD, we have completed two spans, AB and BC. Now we have CD. We have got two more equations. So MCD equal to M of CD plus 2EI by L into 2 theta C plus theta D plus theta D. 2 theta C plus theta D plus 3 delta by L. 3 delta by L. That is the equation. Right. Now this is equal to M of CD is minus 50. M of CD is minus 50 plus 2E into I equal to I naught. For the span CD, I equal to I naught by L equal to 5 meters. For the span CD, L equal to 5 meters into, now here 2 theta C, D is fixed. Here D is fixed, therefore theta D equal to 0. Theta D equal to 0, theta A equal to 0, theta A equal to 0. And delta is also 0. Therefore, theta D is 0. Delta is 0. That's all. So, this is your equation number 5. Equation number 5. Right. Coming to MDC equal to M of DC plus 2EI by L into, it is DC, therefore 2 theta D plus theta C plus 3 delta by L. Now here theta D is 0, delta is 0, so we have only theta C. So this is MAB. Right. Equal to M of DC is plus 50. M of DC is plus 50. Therefore, 50 plus 2E, I equal to I naught only. I equal to I naught by L equal to 5 meters into theta C. That's all. This is equation number 6. So these are the 6 slope deflection equations. There are 3 spans. For all the 3 spans, we have 3 into 2, 6 equations. So you have to write down the general equation, substitute the fixture and moment values, make the zero values, make all zero values just to mark and cancel out. And remaining terms you write. Simplify and write down the equation. Simplification is nothing. Whichever is zero, cancel it. Whatever values are available, fixed moments are available, substitute it. That's all. There is no other tedious. It is not a tedious step. Tedious step. So write like this for three spans. Write down six slope deflection equations. So next is the equilibrium equations. So how many unknowns are there? Because the number of equations and the number of equilibrium equations will have to be the same. Now in this problem, theta b is only on a is 0, theta a 0, theta d 0, delta is 0. Therefore you have got only two unknowns. The two unknowns are theta b and theta c. Theta b and so these are the two unknowns in this, because theta a 0, theta d 0, delta 0, these are the three variables in the slope deflection equation. Each equation, there will be two slopes and one deflection, that's all. Right. So here these are the unknowns. Theta b and theta c are the unknowns. Right. Now coming to the equilibrium equations, effectively utilize the available space, because these equations we want, this is MAB, this is MBA after simplification. Right. Now next is, for want of space I write it here. Third step is equilibrium equation. Equilibrium equations. So there are two unknowns, theta b, theta c. For solving two unknowns, you want two equations. One equation is at b, MBA plus MBC. That is, here, these moments. So MBA and MBC. So MBA, suppose if this is plus 100, MBC will be minus 100. MBC must be minus 100. MBA is plus 100. MBC must be minus 100. Otherwise, joint B will not be under equilibrium. If MBA is plus 70, MBC is minus 70. That's all. So MBA plus MBC when added, the algebraic sum must be equal to 0. Plus 70 minus 70 equals 0, or plus 100 minus 100 equal to 0. Otherwise B will not be under equilibrium. So that is one equilibrium condition. Now for MBA, you have equation number 2. So that means equation 2 you will have to substitute here, plus MBC you have equation number 3. Equation number 3, that is for MBC. MBC, so 2 plus 3 equal to 0. You have to substitute. So MBA equal to, this is the equation 2. So 60 plus 2EI0 by 6 into I0 by 6 into 2 theta B. BA I naught only, yes, 2 theta B plus, so this is equation 2 is 60 plus this, that is equation 2E I naught into 2 theta B, that's correct, plus theta MBC. MBC is minus 24, so here it is minus 24 plus 4EI0 by 5, plus 4EI0 by 5 into 2 theta B plus theta C into 2 theta B plus theta C. So this is equal to 0. This is one equilibrium equation. Now this you have to simplify. Simplification, you have to multiply, simplify and add I will skip that particular step. I have the complete solution, but still I want the board, and also all these equations will be necessary for further substitution. Therefore I will just I want to make use of the board. I want all these equations 1, 2, 6 again I want. Therefore this simplification I leave it to you, because you see EI naught is there, some number is there, theta b theta c is there. After all I am going to expand here and there, manipulate and write down some so many theta b plus so many theta c equal to some number. That's all. That I think the viewers can easily do it. I will write down only the final equation. So adding that is 2.267 theta b plus 0.8 theta c equal to minus 36 by EI naught. This is equation 7. That is adding this and this, expanding, simplifying, you'll get 2.267 theta b plus 0.8 theta c equal to minus 36 by EI naught. I think it will not be a difficult step, expanding, adding, simplifying, taking some terms to the right hand side. It's not a complicated. So that is why, just for want of this board, I want all these equations again. Therefore I just am doing this work, right? So this is one equation. So you got two unknowns. So for two unknowns you want two equations. You got one equation, equation 7, you got it. Next one again, so the viewers will have to adjust. Again I am adjusting the board, that's all. So the next equation is at C MCB plus MCD equal to 0. So here at this joint, MCB plus MCD here must be equal to 0. Algebraic sum must be equal to 0. Now MCB, you have equation 4. Equation 4. MCB is equation 4. MCD is equation 5. MCD. Right. MCB is 36 here. 36 plus 4EI naught by 5. 4E I naught by 5 into 2 theta C plus theta B. 2 theta C plus theta B. That is MCB equation 4 plus equation 5 MCD. MCD, this is minus 50. This continuation of this minus 50 plus 2E I naught by 5, 2E naught I by 5 into 2 theta C. So these two when added must be equal to 0. MCB plus MCD equal to 0. That is equation 4 plus equation 5 when added, that value will have to be equal to 0. That is another equilibrium equation, right? Now again this you have to expand. So this into 2IC, this into theta B, this into 2 theta C, these numbers to the right hand side, all those simplifications you have to do. You have to get another equation. That equation is 0.8 theta b plus 2.4 theta c equal to 14 by EI. This is equation number 8. So equation number 7 is this, equation number 8 is this. So now you have to solve the two equations. This is EI naught. Solve the two equations. That is, one is 2.267 theta b plus 0.8 theta c. The other one is, what you can do is, you can multiply this equation by 3. Multiply this equation by 3 so that 2.267 into 3 theta b plus 3 into 0.8 will be 2.4 theta c equal to this into 3. So that theta c can be cancelled. Theta c can be cancelled because this is 2.4, this is 0.8. Multiply equation 7 by 3. So that will also become 2.4 theta c. So 2.4 theta c, 2.4 theta c, 1 minus the other will give you the. Therefore, you can find out the value of theta b first. After substituting theta b in any one of the equations, you can get the value of theta c. So like that, I will give you the final value of theta b solving. Theta b equal to minus 20.33 by EI naught. Theta c equal to 12.61 by EI naught to EI naught. So that is the third step, writing the equilibrium equations for the two joints. Equilibrium equation for two joints, substituting the equations 2, 3, 4, 5 appropriately, and solving the two equations, you get theta b, theta c. They are the unknowns. So, last step, I think I have to rush up. Last is that of final moments. Final moments. So for getting the final moments, I told you, you have to rewrite the slope deflection equations one by one. So you know, this is equation number 1. In this equation, this is known. Theta b is the only unknown. Theta b is minus 20.33 by EI naught. Actually, here, theta b is the only unknown. So this is equal to minus of 20.33 by EI naught. So EI naught will get cancelled. So 2 into 20.33 by 6 will be a number. Minus 60 by this minus. This is also minus. 2 into 20 by 6. That is 40 by 6. Approximately 40 by 6. So approximately 7. 7. So minus 60, minus 7. So because EI naught will get cancelled. So this value will be equal to minus 66.78 kilonewton meter. Similarly, for MBA, it is 2 theta b. So for theta b, you substitute. Theta b equal to minus 20.33 by EI naught. EI naught will get cancelled. So this will become 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 20, 80 by 6. Approximately 13 or 14. So 60 minus 13. That will be equal to minus 46. 46.45. This value equal to 46.45 kilonewton meter. 46.45 kilonewton meter. Similarly, I'll rush up. So you have to substitute equation number 3. You have to substitute theta b and theta c. Theta b is this, theta c is this, and I naught will get cancelled. Because everywhere you have EI naught in the denominator. So EI naught will get cancelled. You will get a number. That number MBC is minus 46.44. This is equal to minus 46.44. You have to check when MBA is plus 46.44, MBA must be equal to minus 46.44. If that is not equal and opposite, right, then that is something wrong in your calculation. MBA equal to plus 46.45, MBC equal to minus 46.44 kilonewton meter. And MCB is 39.91. MCB, this value equal to 39.91 kilonewton meter. And this is MCD equal to minus 39.91 kilonewton meter. And MDC equal to 55. So this MDC equal to 55.04 kilonewton meter. That is, in the last step, this you cannot straight away write. You have to write down all these equations 1 to 6. Write down all these equations 1 to 6. Substitute theta B, substitute theta C, and then you have to show the values. So you cannot show it in the equation. I am just doing for want of saving time, and also for want of this board, I have to rub off everything and rewrite everything. So that's why so I think viewers can understand my situation. Therefore, simply you have to substitute. So for example, if you take this equation 2EI0 by phi into theta C. Theta C is 12.61 by EI0. So when that is substituted here, this EI0 and EI0 will get cancelled. This is 12, approximately 2 into 12, say 25 by 5 equal to 5. 50 plus 5 equal to 55. And that's what we are getting. So just one more, I repeat. It is 50 plus 2 by 5 EI0 into theta C. Theta C is 12.61 by, say, 12.5. So 2 into 12.5 will be 25. 25 by 5 equal to 5. So 50 plus 5 equal to 55. Right? So 55.04. This you have to write down final moments, reproduce equation 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, substitute the values of theta B, theta C, and show the final number. So this I have not done it, that you have to do it only, then only the problem will be complete. So that will complete the final moments, and then for this you have to draw the bending moment diagram, and then if it is necessary, you have to draw shear force diagram and complete the problem. So this is a lengthy problem, so I am not doing bending moment diagram here. So this is how you have to complete a problem on a continuous beam. We will do more number of problems in the future classes. For one or two problems, I will draw the bending moment diagram and a shear force diagram. So for this lecture, we will stop with this. Thank you.